To import data using Report Reader, we need to create one or more layers. The first layer is called the base layer, and it contains the lowest level of detail in the file. We need to select a sample line for each layer that is representative of all of the lines that we want to import in that layer. In this example, the base layer will contain all of the detailed lines that contain the data for the PIN, employee class, date, amount, and other fields. For the sample line, choose the first line that represents this type of data. To select a sample line, click and hold the mouse button on the sample line and drag it slightly right or left to highlight the line. Then release the mouse button. A dialog appears asking what type of layer to create. For the purposes of this example, we will use standard layers only. Click Yes to create a standard layer. A copy of the sample line we selected appears at the top between two yellow lines. This is called the anchor line. The next step is to define a trap. A trap tells IDEA which lines to import by specifying what all of the lines have in common. Place your cursor above the anchor line at the very beginning of the line. If we type 122, we can see that the first four lines of data are highlighted. This trap tells IDEA that all of the lines we want to import must have 122 in the first three characters. Any line starting with 122 would be imported. This is not what we want, so let's delete those characters. Move the cursor above DA and type DA. This trap tells IDEA to import any lines with DA in that position. This is also not what we want. IDEA has four generic traps that serve as wildcards. The four traps are the text trap for alphabetical characters, the numeric trap for digits 0 through 9, the space trap for blank spaces, and the non-blank trap for any text that is not blank space. Above DA, let's enter two text traps by clicking the text trap button on the toolbar twice. Our first two attempts at creating a trap were too restrictive, but this trap here is too general. We included every line of the data that we want to import, but we also are catching additional lines that are not similar to the sample line. Delete the two text traps and put the cursor over the date. Use a series of numeric traps and slashes to define a trap that includes any line with a date in that location in that format. Now, only the detail lines that look like our sample line are highlighted, and there are no additional lines. This is exactly what we want. Our trap is set, and now it's time to go on to the next step.